Okay, the LG ok75 and 99 also have an app. It's only available on Android. It's called Music Flow Bluetooth. And some of the functionality and stuff can be found in the app. I'm not going to go all through the app. You can play with it yourself. But basically, it's a music player. It's like iTunes or any of the other ones. Okay, the DJ loop button here, if you push that and hold it down, it'll repeat 1 second of sound. So you can only do it with a USB and a CD. It'll just keep repeating. It'll only do it up to 10 times. Your DJ effect button. Apparently you push this and you can pick one and you can turn the level of it up and down, and this will actually change the sound of the song. So we play a song and use the DJ effect. So another thing JBL doesn't do that the LG does is it has a user equalizer. So you push this, there's your bass, you can turn it up or down, mid-range and treble. Yeah, JBL doesn't have this, and it actually does work and it does make a difference. You also have the bass blast. So if you hold this down until it reads bass, you get a lot more bass out of the speaker. And yes, it does make a big difference. Next, yeah, your little turntables will scratch. Turn it up a bit. You get back two different sounds, one in each direction. Same thing over here. Let's see, so you can kind of play with it. Also serve other functions, like I showed you when you use the equalizer, you got to use this. And the search function is for, I think it's for the radio. If you have the radio on, you can press search and turn this, and it'll adjust the station for you. Obviously, OK means to select whatever you're trying to select. Another thing this has is a clock. It has an alarm clock. It has a sleep timer, none of which the JBL has. The party starter is basically just a sound effect. The bar starter. And you can load your own sounds in here also. These are standard ones. And I believe if you hold these down, so now they're all clubbed. You have three different drums. One of them really should be a bass as far as I'm concerned. And then your user sounds, these are the ones that you can load in there using a USB. You can load three of your own sounds in. It's got to be MP3. The lighting changes the light settings. I'll show you that a little later. One other item here. You got a special equalizer, which is basically equalizer presets, just like your phone does. India for different kinds of music, funk. Yeah, there's a bunch of them. I always use the user EQ or the bass blast, depending on what I'm listening to. I don't really mess with that too much, but I'm sure it comes in handy. Also, another thing that JBL does not do. That said, I keep comparing this to the JBL because that's really, the, as far as I'm concerned, the comparable speaker to this. And the DJ pad on the JBL is way more intuitive than this is, and it's a lot simpler to use. The simple fact is this just has a lot more functionality. And, you know, some people like that, some people don't. I really don't use much of it. You know, if I had a few cocktails, I use it. I try to use everything, but generally, I don't use that much of it. So your remote control. The auto DJ button is something that is not on the unit itself. So what the auto DJ does is it will automatically blend the end of a song with the beginning of the next song. So you have no pause or anything. It just kind of blends them together, which is a nice effect if you're just playing a playlist and letting it roll. Makes it sound a little more professional. You have a lot of buttons on here that are on the thing, obviously. Volume, you know, your function button, etc. I'm not going to go through all through them. But you can skip and play and repeat a song. You can do all that. Something else that JBL doesn't do, you can't control your player with the JBL the way you can here. Sound effect is basically, I believe it's one of these effects and it just does one. Your regional equalizer, which is something I just showed you here, which, you know, changes your equalizer settings. This has a sleep. It has the key changer and the voice canceller, which is great. I don't see a microphone volume on here. And I really think if you're going to have a key changer, you got to have a microphone volume. And I could be wrong. There may be a way to push something here and make that happen. I'm just not sure what it is. It would take me 2 weeks to try to figure out every function on this thing, to be honest with you. Yeah, you can set your clock, which is on the top. Doesn't really do you much good unless you're standing over it, looking at it. Not a big deal. The alarm's nice. If you want to use it as an alarm clock, you can. Sleep is cool, so it shuts off on its own after a while. And I would have to go through a couple of these other things to figure out what they are. But, yeah, this is a nice touch to the speaker, I think. This is the only negative I find is I can't get full volume just using my phone. It only goes up to 25. So I either have to have the remote or use the volume on the unit itself, which is kind of a pain in the neck. It's a pain in the ass, but don't tell anybody I said that. Even on the app, I can only get to 25 volume. I can't get to 40. It's a little more than halfway, unfortunately. That's the one thing I don't like. It drives me nuts. Because if I only have my phone with me, I can only get 25 out of it. I have to, like I said, use the remote or walk all the way over here, turn this up manually, and manual sucks. So, that's kind of a downfall. It really is a big pain in the neck. I believe that's pretty much it for functionality on the LG ok99. And like I said, it covers the 75 as well. The only difference between the two is this orange light around the turntables. Other than that, the tops of these things are the exact same. I probably missed some functions, so don't yell at me in the comments. If you know something I don't, feel free. Stick it up there. Let me know. And then if I do another in-depth feature review on these things, I'll definitely share that with everybody. Like, originally I didn't know that these could be paired together, but they can. And one of my viewers filled me in on that, and I appreciate it. So, yeah, they can be paired. The speakers can be paired together. They're not stereo, unfortunately. One other thing that JBL does better, you can pair a set of JBLs, and they will be stereo. These won't do that. LG, you gotta fix that, man. We need stereo. But this 99, let me tell you something. I had no problem packing up that JBL to send it back after listening to this thing the other night. This thing rocks the house. Okay, everybody, we're on to the light functionality of the LG ok75 and the LG ok99. They have the same light settings. I'm going to have some music on for this, so because some of the lights go to the beat, obviously. So let's start out with off. Alright, so you have an off setting, obviously. Your next setting is called rhythm. This is supposed to go to the rhythm.
Back in the room, it's much too real. In comes life that I must feel. But can't look forward to.
I'm also going to give you the bass boost here. I'm going to turn that on mid-song.
That to the truth that sticks in me. like a war. Oh dear. Tied to machines that make me be. Cut this life off from me. I hold my breath as I wish for death. Oh please God wake me.
Okay, so that's rhythm. That's rhythm, the rhythm setting on the lights. Yeah, this speaker also has a volume meter on the front, which I really like, because you can see where the volume is from across the room if you're using your remote control or your phone. So I do like that feature. I think that's a great feature both speakers put in, the JBL and the LG, obviously. All right, so the next setting on the lighting is called Party. This setting is called Party. Sorry, I had a little email come through that. Then you got Water, so it's kind of like uses blues and greens more. And then you have Forest, which uses greens more, greens and yellows. Basically, the difference I see is more in the woofer. I'm not seeing too much difference up here. City Club. That's a little slow for my taste. That's it, and then backed off. So you got 10 different light settings or so. Let me see, there's Rhythm, Party, Firework, Space, Water, Forest, City Glow, and then off again. My favorite by far, Party's pretty cool. I do like Party. Fireworks okay.
Done, done, on to the next one, done, done, and 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 on to the next one.
That concludes the light functionality review on the LG. And I gotta tell you, honestly, I love these lights way better than the JBL. The JBL, the strobes are way too weak. If the strobes were brighter, it would be cool, but they're not bright enough. These things blast you at night when it's dark in here, which if you go take a look at my night video, you'll see that. Between the lights and the volume on this thing and the fact that it holds its sound all the way through the volume, this is the speaker I recommend. For larger areas especially, for a big backyard, if you want to do some kind of reception hall or, you know, wherever, your bar, your neighborhood bar, if you want to fill up a room with some loud ass music, this is the speaker for you. For a smaller area, most normal living rooms and houses, the 75 is more than enough. This thing is plenty loud, trust me when I tell you that. I don't want to sound biased here, but I really believe that JBL was going to destroy these two speakers before I got them here. But I got to tell you, I'm going to be honest with you guys, because you're my viewers, you're important. These speakers have impressed me way more than that JBL did. I was actually let down with the JBL. It let me down a good bit on the volume on the thing. The clarity is darn near perfect up to half volume. But once you get above half volume, it ain't worth it. That thing's packed up, ready to go. But yeah, I love both these speakers. They rock. I'm a loudspeaker guy. I like the house to shake with the bass, and both of these speakers do it. This thing, if your room's small enough, I think it might actually blow the glass out of the windows. But they are both awesome speakers, and I definitely recommend these over to JBL. JBL's $1,000, $700, $500. You can't go wrong. With the increased functionality, it's a little less intuitive, but with the increased functions, the sound, and the lights, these are the speakers. I'll tell you, these are the winners by far. Thanks for watching, everybody. Remember to click like and subscribe if you like the video. I really appreciate y'all watching, and I got a lot more of this kind of stuff to come, so enjoy. Thank you.